Hello friends, welcome to you all to Vyapar Learning Hub. Today in this tutorial video, we will tell you how to add stock inventory, meaning items, or how you can add your products. So let's start. Firstly, open Vyapar. Friends, before adding products, we would like to tell you that biggest benefit of Vyapar app is that you can use options as per your need. And all these options are present in settings. And this facility make Vyapar app simple and user friendly for you all. So before adding items or products, let me take you to settings from where you can turn on the options which you require. To do that, go to settings option in left menu. Here you will see other options. Because we have to do item related settings, so we will go to item settings. Over here you will get all the options related to items. And some settings are by default turned on, like enable items, stock maintenance and all. But for now we only have to turn on settings which we need while adding items. Like items unit. If you maintain the stock in units, then turn this on. But if you deal in items for which units is same, then you can turn on default unit option and assign a default unit for all the items. If you want to categorize items, then you can turn on item category option. After this you will see two options: item wise tax and discount by default are turned on. If they are not on, then you can turn them on. On right side you will find serial number and batch tracking option. This means if you want to manage the stock serial number wise or batch wise, then you can turn these options on. For now we have turned on all the options. So now let's see how to add items. For this, come out of settings and in left menu you will find items option. Click on it. If you are adding item for the first time, then you will see the screen like this. On the top there are options like products, services, categories from where you can create categories, units from where you can manage units, and my online store. So here you have to click on add your first product button. You can see add item window is open. So here you can enter all the details like item name, item HSN, or you can click on search item to search HSN. Then categories, as we have not made categories, so it will be saved in general category by default. Later on you can shift it to other categories. Item code, and after that select unit. Suppose there are 12 bottles in one box, then in base unit we will see box, and in secondary unit bottles. In conversion rate, we will mention 12, as I said before, and click on save button to save it. In the bottom there are three tabs: pricing, stock and item range. So here first in pricing we will add the details, sale price. Then you will select the price which you have entered has tax included or excluded. After that similarly add purchase price, and this also is including or excluding tax. Here you will select tax rate of the item. After this you get a very important option to fix the discount on the item. So here if you want an amount or in percentage, set the discount. Then you can go to stock section, and here you have to select if you want to add this item with batch details or with serial number. If you select batch, and if we go to add details, then screen will look like this. Here you can enter all the details like MRP, batch number, model, manufacturing date, expiry date, and quantity, and save it. If you select serial number, then screen will look like this. Here you can add serial number and save it. Your opening quantity will be updated automatically. Here add price is used for opening quantity. This means the stock which you have added as opening quantity, what is the per unit price of it. After that you would select the date on which opening balance needs to be shown. And then you will get minimum stock to maintain option, which is a very important feature, because on the basis of which you get alert window of low stock or reports. So you can enter the quantity count according to you, which means if the item comes to this minimum quantity or is less than that, then it will be shown to low stock. Next is location, which you use according to your need. Like if you keep the products systematically then the product is in which rack and which box can be mentioned here, which will help you in searching the items. Like in pharmacy business or spare business, this is required a lot. After that, there is item image section where you can add maximum 5 images related to the item, which can help you in making online store. So we have added all the details of the items, and if after this you have to add more items, then you can use save and new button. But for now, we have clicked on save button and saved it. After saving, your items list will be ready and will look like this. On right, you will find items details and transactions. You can add items whenever needed. If apart from that you have item list with all the details, like in Excel, then you can import the button together. For that, you can go to utilities section on left menu. Over here, you can get item to import item. So here, click on download button and get the sample format and save it. Now open that format and fill in all the details of the items in this manner and save it. After that, open Vyapar and click on click here to browse option and select the saved file and import it. So you can see all your items are imported and you can use them for billing. We hope that you liked the video. Like the video and share it with your business friends. For more information, contact us on the details shown on screen. For more videos, subscribe our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to be first to see our videos. Thank you for using Vyapar. Happy Vyaparing!